Hey, hello, welcome, good evening. Obsidian had a new update today. Kind of a small one, but pretty interesting one. A few weeks ago, a month ago, probably in May sometime, they did a new PDF reader that had a little bit nicer appearance. It didn't really add much functionality then, but now we've got something added to it that's kind of neat. Probably, I assume, the first step onto bigger plans for it, considering expanding a lot, it seems like. They really want people to give, they want to give everyone all the tools they could possibly need in Obsidian, in a toggleable turn off, turn on type of way, and then also supplement that with community plugins when needed. You know, it's kind of like what Canvas was. That's why we've got Obsidian Publish, right? And so now, what did they add? Just like a few hours ago, earlier today, this is currently only in for insiders, so you have to be a Catalyst member, which means you made a one-time payment of 25 buckaroonies. And then, presumably, week or two is generally the time frame. It'll be available to all people using Obsidian, regardless of whether you've paid any money, not paid any money, anything like that. Whatever type of license you have. It's also right now only available on desktop. They're pretty good about eventually rolling everything into both versions, the mobile and the desktop version. So it's probably just a matter of time. But I assume that anything PDF related probably just takes a little bit more testing to get it to a workable state on the mobile device. You know, if only because it's less fluid, right, than just like a regular markdown note that you might have in there. So that alone is probably requires multiple, you know, development pathways versus just like working with the main notes. It's probably just going to translate very easily, I would guess. So the main addition, as far as the PDF reader is concerned, is added support for deep linking in PDFs. Links can be generated via the PDF context menu. And then we've got the link types that you can do. And then the parameters if you want to either handwrite a note or a link or edit a link. Or, you know, just get an idea of what it means when it puts that URL link into your note. We've got three link types. So outline section with the parameter, or link to outline section. So PDFs are somewhat advanced. They can have, you know, table of contents in there. They can have comments and annotations. They can have a whole bunch of extra metadata added in there. And if you have a PDF that has one of those things, you can link straight to one of the little table of contents headers. You can also link straight to arbitrary text, and you can link to annotations. Now, you cannot make annotations in Obsidian on PDFs right now. Right now, what you can do is if you have a PDF that already has highlights and annotations from another piece of software, those can be linked to in a, you know, a simple text link in your notes. And you cannot transclude parts of a PDF into notes in the same way that you can transclude parts of other notes into other notes. People are asking about this a lot on the Reddit thread announcing it, and I don't really understand the need for that. Like, I think really what you need, and I'll show you how to do the linking in a second, but because PDFs are generally static, you know, like, yeah, sure, you can highlight them, you can leave some comments or whatever, but those are done on a separate kind of layer, you know? The PDF itself doesn't change, so I don't think transcluding, in this case, is like a thing that really makes sense to me. Maybe I'm wrong, I'm not a smart person. Anyway, so I'll show you how to do the links. It's very simple. I've tossed a PDF in here. Flippy, 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 flippy to a random page. And let me just highlight this right here. Highlight the heading, right click. We got two options. We got copy. We've got copy link to selection. So copy, as you can imagine, is going to copy the text there. Highlight, right click, copy link to selection. Now we'll paste it. Boom, we've got a link right there. Let me close that tab with that PDF there. PDF's not open no more. It's all gone. Click. Goes right back there. Easy peasy. Super simple. I don't have a PDF with annotations, unfortunately, right now to check that out. I assume it's exactly the same way, except you're right-clicking on a different spot of the PDF. Pretty much that's got to be it, right? Oh, it's kind of cool. Okay, this does have a table of contents. Let's see. So if I, can I right-click this, copy link to selection, paste. Now we've got there. So as you can see, so the first one is hashtag page equals 111 and selection 20215, which as you can see is kind of like the way that it's set up here on the examples from the release notes. Let's close that PDF again, open this link up. Magic and technology. Oh, see, we got the little, we got that right there, which is cool. We got the little hover thing. Let's clicky and boom right there to the opening of that selection. So I did that. I didn't even have that page actually up in the PDF. I just right clicked on the table of contents. Done. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty neat. I haven't used Obsidian to store PDFs. Like, there's definitely been some, there's some reference type stuff that's in there. But if I'm, like, reading a PDF and taking notes, I've been using Readwise's Reader app for that. It's kind of okay. PDFs, in general, I guess their versatility comes at a cost, it seems like, because you really need a dedicated, like, Zotero or something like that for it, it seems, to really get all of the, make use of all of the functionality available. Pretty cool, pretty interesting. Bam! Let's do this.